please.
Assalamu alaikum. Kindly tell us what is the relationship between Adal and Ihsan, especially in view of the sermon that you once gave.
I was delivered lectures, longish lectures in Jalsa Salana.
Yes.
You want me to deliver another lecture here?
No, I just want to know that how is it that Adal ke baghair Ihsan ho nahi sakta? This I could not understand.
You think it can be done?
No, I do not know the correct meaning of Ihsan.
No, what I said was right in the beginning that unless you establish Adal, that is complete justice, you cannot conceive of any Ihsan. Ihsan must have a fundamental base of Adal, otherwise it cannot be built. Because that Ihsan, whatever you call it later on, is not Ihsan. In the name of Ihsan, something you do, which is not Ihsan at all. For instance, a mother can be kind to her own sons and you think it is Ihsan, while at the same time she is being unkind to other wards which are her stepsons. So if she is being cruel, she cannot be a Mohsina.
Correct.
So without establishing the fundamentals, one can't get to the higher rung of the ladder. That is impossible. This is what is meant by the Holy Quran when it first always repeats this in the same order. Adal is kept first and is paid greatest stress upon. Then comes Ihsan, then Ita'iz al-Qurba, which is a rare quality among the rare people of Allah, but this is the highest man can reach to.
Correct. There is Adal maintained between the celestial bodies floating in the space. Similarly, if we throw a handful of pebbles onto this pseudo camera, some will strike, some will go astray. Every pebble has got its own circle, and they do not overstep each other. So that is also Adal. There is Adal in every way in this life. Here the sound does not happen.
I have also spoken of this in my Jalsa Salana speech.
Right.
What is meant by Ihsan in the law of nature?
Yes.
There are manifestations of Ihsan in everywhere, in animate as well as inanimate creation. And that can be established positively, but not in such a short sitting like this.
Yes.
I think if you read the last speech of Jalsa Salana, there I have quoted quite a few examples of Ihsan in the universe.
In the universe.
Yes.
Jazakallah. Ramanayam.
Anything else, please? Tell Muhammad Abdul Rashid. This is between you now. You are sitting close to
me. He told me he has questions, but I don't know if he is the one that I don't mind.
You didn't give him a chance at all to say yes or no. He said something and walked up to
Would you like to come?
No?
In the Holy Quran, sir, in Surah Furqan, Allah Ta'ala has said, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبَّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. Could you kindly give us the background of this and which tongue is involved in this and which Nabi was involved, who was told this, please?
Ahmad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told that during the, on the day of resurrection, our Rasul, that is Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will complain to Allah that these my people, once having been bestowed the Holy Quran, left it and deserted it as unattended. This would be the complaint made against his own people by Ahadra sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but not people of his own time, but people of the latter days. Because there is another tradition of Ahadra sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which makes the whole thing very clear. He says, Yati alannase zamanu lam yabqa min al-Qur'an illa ismuhu or la yabqa min al-Qur'an illa ismuhu wa la yabqa min al-Islam la yabqa min al-Islam illa ismuhu wa la yabqa min al-Qur'an illa rasmuhu, which says, among other things, that the Holy Qur'an will be only for writing and for the scripts to make beautiful writings out of it. It will have nothing to do with human life and modeling the character of Muslims. Only it will be a thing of ornament which the scribes will take pride and vie with each other that we write better and we write in gold threads and this and that. So لا يبقى من الإسلام من القرآن إلا رسمه means nothing of the Quran will be left but the writing. So when this is going to happen according to his own tradition and the day of the resurrection is after this, obviously this is what he is referring to. That an unfortunate time is to come when my own so-called people, followers, will desert me and the Holy Quran. The Quran will only be for the writings and Islam would only be in name. La yabqa min al-Islam illa ismu.
So this, he said, will be one of the reasons for Hazrat Masih Maud to come?
Obviously, yes.
This, I see, thanks.
Could he? Okay.
This I was reading Tafsir Kabir, and I'll read a little bit from this and then question. Hazrat Muslim Maud رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ says, میرے نزدیک اسلام کو اتنا نقصان کسی چیز نے نہیں پہنچایا جتنا نقصان قاہرہ دمشق بغداد بخارا وغیرہ نے پہنچایا ہے. ان شہروں نے لوگوں کی توجہ مذہبی مراکز سے ہٹا کر اپنی طرف کر لی. اگر سب سے بڑے شہر مکہ اور مدینہ ہوتے تو یہ خرابی پیدا نہ ہوتی. یونیورسٹیاں بغداد میں بنی حالانکہ ان کا صحیح مقام مدینہ تھا. اسی طرح قاہرہ میں بنی حالانکہ مکہ میں ہونی چاہیے تھی. پس جو قوم اپنی روحانیت اور علمی طاقت کو پھیلانا چاہتی ہے اس کے لیے ضروری ہے کہ اس کا مرکز ہی آباد ہو. Could you kindly explain?
This is self-explanatory.
Yeah, but you know, we make new centers for expansion, but over here, sir.
No, but they are sub-centers drawing their strength from the center. They don't shift the entire attraction of the center towards themselves and become centers at the cost of the original center. They are different things altogether. Sub-centers always come into creation when you spread out, but not at the cost of the center. If the nucleus is broken down and other nuclei are created, then in fact new animals come into being out of those nuclei. But if there is the central strong nucleus and small other sub-centers are also established within the animal kingdom, that is called growth of organism. For instance, when considered the human being, there are billions of sub-centers in the body. Yet the main center, which is brain, is overpowering them and it remains the attraction of all those sub-centers. This is called organism. If you hit the brain and destroy it, then every individual center in the body would become the center by itself. And then it will be a dead body waiting for ultimate death. For instance, if you look at the slaughtered cow, you will see that much after it has the life has ebbed out of it,